Bank runs, food runs, dollar collapse. If you think you know where we are, you don't, and if you think you do not know where we are, you are right. The Fed has gone hypernuclear with repo and bailouts programs. They are literally flooding America and the world with US dollars, nationalizing entire industries inside the US. The US dollar isn't a safe haven either. And the people who are buying US dollars are about to blow up and watch their purchasing power evaporate. Because we all assume the Fed can create as much money as it wants. That it can create tens of trillions of dollars. Remember, we're bailing out everybody, bailing out the airlines and bailing out the hotels and bailing out the manufacturers and bailing out the plane manufacturers. The automobile manufacturers. Bailing out the individual workers. This is a bailout nation. We're bailing out everybody. How can we bail out everybody? Who's going to do the bailing? The government doesn't have any money. It only has money that it takes from the people. Peter Schiff warns that the real crash that's coming is a dollar crisis. This is fascism, the blending or marriage of corporate and state. The central banks are behind it all. And who are the families that control the central banks? Most of us here understand who it is and all it infers. A world of neo-feudalism. A world of debt slaves. A world of the haves and the have-nots, on an uneven scale that the world did not even see during the golden age of the robber barons. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. Please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels. I do upload videos there, too, on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you. Peter Schiff warns, the real crash is here. On Wednesday, March 18, Peter Schiff did a live episode of his podcast and took questions for over 4 hours. In a nutshell, Peter made the case that the real crash is here. He covered a wide range of topics relating to the ongoing and ever-evolving coronavirus crisis. As far as the mainstream narrative out there, Peter said, everybody has lost their minds. This is really the most idiotic thing I've ever seen. And, you know, the economy is about to implode. That much is pretty sure. Peter is not talking about the steps being taken to hunker down in an effort to slow the spread of coronavirus. He's talking about what everybody is saying the government needs to do to address the economic downturn. In 2007, Peter Schiff wrote a book, Crash Proof, How to Profit from the Coming Economic Collapse. He followed that up with The Real Crash, America's Coming Bankruptcy, How to Save Yourself and Your Country. He gave his second book that title because 2008 wasn't the real crash. It's the one that's about to happen. Peter said it took longer than he thought it would get to this point. But here we are. That bubble has now popped. Believe me. I had no idea that the pin to pop this bubble would be the coronavirus. This pin has pricked the biggest bubble that the Federal Reserve has ever inflated. And now the air is coming out. And at this point, it doesn't even matter what happens to that pin. The damage is already done. The cat's out of this bag. This bubble has popped. And there is a lot of air that's going to come out of it. One example of the craziness is the call for helicopter money. The term refers to giving money directly to individuals as if dropping cash on everybody out of a helicopter. As Peter pointed out, when Milton Friedman coined the term, it was a joke. He was using it as an example of what not to do, about why Keynesian monetary stimulus doesn't work. He said it's a crazy, stupid idea. It's like dropping money from helicopters. Because dropping money from helicopters doesn't do anything. It's just inflation. It just makes prices go up. We don't need more money. We need more stuff. Adding money doesn't add anything of value. It's just paper. Donald Trump has been comparing the coronavirus crisis in World War II. Peter made the point that in World War II, there weren't any corporate bailouts. Not only did people not get bailout checks from the government, but the government also tripled taxes. Last week, Peter asked the question, has the bond bubble just been pricked? It appears that it has. Bond prices are collapsing almost as fast as stocks. Now people are piling into the dollar. All the money the Fed is printing isn't going to have value. It isn't going to buy anything. Prices are going to skyrocket. And in fact, this coronavirus is accelerating that process because the coronavirus is reducing the supply of goods available to buy. This is the perfect storm for price inflation. We'll have more money chasing fewer actual goods. People are advocating the same monetary policies that have destroyed every country that has ever tried it. Weak dead virus bounce today, the race for the bottom will resume tomorrow. Wow, big bounce from a 3-year low. Over 100 Dow points. Everything is great again. Trillions of dollars pumped into this great market, we got over 100 Dow points. Yay. I find it particularly entertaining how it has become the norm that when the fraud markets begin to resume their collapse through the casino floor, a strategic announcement of a press conference containing absolutely nothing substantive or material relative to the pandemic or the crumbling US economy is the catalyst for 800, 1000 plus point rallies on the Dow Jones Propaganda Index. Don't you? The US stock is now down 50% from its highs as world loses $25 trillion in a month. Global stock and bond markets have seen $25 trillion of paper wealth erased in the last month, wiping out all the gains from the December 2018 crash lows. And those paper millionaires in 29 lost a fortune. We are being played by the virus. Absolute carnage and detestation, all in the name of what looks to be a phony hoax virus panic. That wealth and those assets will never return. You buy a stock for a dollar. The value goes to a million, then goes back down to a dollar. What did you lose? On the other hand, my old relic yellow metal, which cannot be even eaten, has doubled in value compared to dollars since I bought it. The stock market is a zero-sum game. No one loses anything. Someone buys, someone sells. Just because the smart money and cash is on the sidelines and the stupid money buys stocks at bubble prices and pisses and cries when the price goes down, though. Nothing is lost. Wealth is moved from the stupid to the smart. Just like every day. Boomer retirees are getting absolutely ASS blasted. Terrible timing for this crash with our largest retiree population ever. It's not like they haven't received countless warnings for decades upon decades. Boomers are the crop. The wealth they generated is being harvested by them. They are meant to die broke. The connected traders are going to buy every dip and sell every rip between now and the next several years, making money both ways until we are at Dow 5000. This isn't going to start and end in 1 month. It is going to take several presidencies to unwind this Mount Everest of doo-doo. Computers and the algorithms lost nothing compared to the people and their 401ks. That's why they suckered all the retail investors in so they could get out. 25 trillion is an imaginary number. That being said, every so often, a crisis happens to fleece the retirements, retail investors. How much was talent, and how many dollars put by the wayside when US jobs were sent offshore and lied about? How many in the US middle class, with high IQs, and 2 and 3 master's degrees, were sidelined, unemployed, ran up credit card debt, lost health benefits, lost mortgages, when US jobs were sent offshore and lied about? Good effin' riddance to the CEOs, Wall Street traders, bank executives, hedge fund managers, and oligarchs who have lost money. The way I see it is that we're at the levels of the late 2018 lows, S&P 2320 more or less. We're also at the highest point in 20 years on the VIX and stubbornly staying there for the past 4 days. No convincing bounce away from these levels yet. Everything shut down with no end in sight. Massive bazookas were all futile. The derivatives bubble should be bursting right about now. I see 2100 near term, I think we're going through these levels. Can't you see the QE and repo loans is exactly not what the Fed should be doing? Throwing money at this problem is like tossing pure ethanol on a fire. Values will disappear before our very eyes, then get the wheelbarrows out to haul your fiat around to buy bread. We're in the eye of the financial hurricane. Money won't fix anything. Debt needs to be reduced. Debt-based currency needs to be abolished, period. We've all been ass-blasted from the get-go of the creation of this monster. Every dollar created devalues the previously printed notes, and then they charge us interest to borrow them. The government has an unlimited overdraft facility with the banks enslaving our children with their borrowing. Their very existence depends on counterfeiting money and hoping for an avalanche of newborns to fill the Ponzi vacancies of the retirees and the heavenly departed. Loving my American experiment. Just as in nature, so it is in the business world. Survival of the fittest. Welcome back to the Atlantis Report. The genie is out of the bottle. A lot of people have seen the futility of their lives, constantly ripped off by the banks, employed by the slaver corporations, lied to by politicians, manipulated by social media, spied on by everyone else. If 25 meters of them survive for a month by not going to work, they won't go back. So good luck with herding cats, and even better luck with the cork. At the end of the 1920s, the US was a Ponzi scheme of overinflated asset prices. The use of neoclassical economics and the belief in free markets made them think that overinflated asset prices represented real wealth accumulation. 1929 wakey, wakey time. In other words, whatever the Fed is doing, it's not working. Let's have another go. In 2020, the global economy was a Ponzi scheme of overinflated asset prices. Oh blimey. Everyone wanted to grow GDP, but no one knew what it was. They spent their time faffing about transferring existing assets between one another, e.g., real estate and financial assets, but this does not add to GDP. The Americans worked it out in the 1930s but had forgotten again by the 1980s. Where had all that wealth gone to? In the 1930s, they pondered over where all that wealth had gone to in 1929 and realized inflating asset prices doesn't create real wealth. They came up with a GDP measure to track real wealth creation in the economy. The transfer of existing assets, like stocks and real estate, doesn't create real wealth and, therefore, does not add to GDP. The real wealth creation in the economy is measured by GDP. Inflated asset prices aren't real wealth, and this can disappear almost overnight, as it did in 1929 and 2008. Real wealth creation involves real work, producing new goods and services in the economy. Instead of sending me a check for $1,000, they can send me 20 by 1 ounce $50 face value golden eagles. The Fed is an illness for which there is no cure. Time for a miracle recovery and unlockdown followed by the government self-glorification for swift measures which averted disaster, as the newly fleeced herd cry out for yet taller fences to ease their anxieties while wondering where all the grass has gone. Virus aside, the market was 100% overvalued thanks to easy money by the Fed. Dow 15K, S&P 2K on the way. Due to this meltdown and to save on energy costs, the light at the end of the tunnel will be turned off. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, subscribe, and please take some time to subscribe to my backup channels. I do upload videos there, too, on a daily basis. You'll find the links in the description box. You will also find a PayPal link if you want to make a donation. Thank you.